All right, what is going on, guys? My name is Toby. Welcome to the full results breakdown of the pay-per-view. If you want to hear us, me and Mr. Hurricane are going to be live here very shortly, breaking down the full pay-per-view, taking your calls, getting your thoughts on it in one of the better pay-per-views of the year. Let's go through them right away and just give you the no-nonsense results. Hurricane, pre-show, did you enjoy the match at all? Did you watch it?
I was trying to get my pay-per-view ordered during that time, so I didn't see the pre-show.
Miz was able to beat Cody Rhodes at the figure four leg lock, kind of boring. The first match of the night, a lot of people thought was going to steal the show. I had high hopes for this one. I thought Chris Jericho would carry Fandango, and everybody was expecting Fandango to finally make a good wrestling debut. And I'm going to tell you right away, I thought he looked like crap. It looked like he was rusty, and he was relying all on Chris Jericho.
I had the bar set pretty low for this match, and it was the proper way to just get it out of the way, because it wasn't anything special. It was Jericho and him just carrying a short match.
The highlight of this match was Summer Rae. My God, she looked sexy in that dress. Whew. No, it wasn't necessarily a bad match. There was two botches in there that were pretty noticeable. The problem was Fandango was looking to Jericho for what to do, and he kept that, you know, like he would wait, and Chris would be like, come on, get up, dude. And he would finally get up, and then he would hit a move on him. The finish was awesome, though. It was the most clean catching finisher in a long time. Chris Jericho hit a codebreaker finish to beat Fandango. And where's this feud going to go?
How does Fandango look after this match? He got his offense in early, which he worked pretty good as a heel initially. And then it was all Jericho, a couple botches, and Lion Salt Walls. Codebreaker.
Well, I didn't go exactly in that order because Fandango did start to get a little bit of momentum at the end, but it wasn't enough. I don't know. I think either way, it wasn't as great of a match as I thought it was going to be. The first few matches were super short compared to what I was expecting. Dean Ambrose took on Kofi Kingston in an unpredictable fashion. Like we thought, Kofi Kingston loses the belt to Dean Ambrose. Kofi had a trouble in paradise on Dean, but Dean was on the outside and he rolled out. Kofi brought him in. And what do you think about JBL when he said, why don't you just let him count him out? If he had let Dean Ambrose get counted out, he could have retained his title. He didn't do that.
Huh?
He didn't do that. Dean, in the end, Kofi went for a trouble in paradise. Missed it in the cell. You saw that, right? When he goes on the ropes, comes down, Dean hits his finisher. I thought that was a perfect ending. And Dean captures the United States gold.
And he looks strong.
He looked very strong. And hopefully,
and with the U.S. title, the mid-card belt being now with the Shield, we know the Shield are going to remain strong for a while. Finally, the title is not going to be used to put over other wrestlers.
Maybe. Hopefully, that's what they're going to do and kind of bring back some prestige to it. Next was Sheamus taking on Mark Henry in a match I thought was going to suck. I honestly was like, you know what? I don't know about it. Major botch before this match even started. Did you see it?
No, I missed it. I saw your tweet, though.
Okay, Mark Henry, they had like a T-bar behind all the ring posts with green light for Sheamus, red light for Mark Henry. Mark Henry is coming into the ring, nails his head on the post, and it was pretty hilarious. A little continuity issues with this match. The match itself, what did you think, Hurricane? I thought it was pretty good. I enjoyed it.
Overall, it was really good, especially because I get really scared when I see Sheamus in a match. Because I just usually think he's going to dominate. And he did have good control of this match, but I thought that the, what do you call them, spots in a strap match where they go around and only hit three out of the four turnbuckles. It was pretty good, but the finish was where it got weird.
I will say, okay, this is, you exactly brought it up here. During the match, they would hit, you know, numerous times. They would hit three corners and then they'd get stopped because they would get in a little skirmish and the referee would wave it off. The finish had Sheamus hitting three corners, and Mark Henry playing linebacker, like you said on your Twitter, and that's at Mr. Hurricane, by the way. And Sheamus went running up. Mark Henry grabbed him midair, was going to go for a finish, throws him over his head, hits a bro kick, and then hits the final corner, which the ref should have waved off all three of the flag every other time he did it.
Yeah, there was one time where Henry, I think, had three touches, and it was something very minor that waved off the count.
He just, like, hit him or something. He's super simple, and he waved off the count. You know, overall, it was still a pretty good strap match.
Yeah, overall, it was good because they were creative in the way they were going around and hit the turnbuckles. Like, Sheamus was on the outside once, and Henry was, I think he had him, like, tied up like a cow.
Yeah,
it was a good strap match. You can't do much better. You're pretty limited in the strap match.
It was pretty good. Next up, I really don't even care for this match. Zeb cut a really racist promo, but before, I really liked it. First of all, even though a lot of people were hating on it. Mike Chioda asked a lot of times if you want to quit at the start of the match. Now, granted, it is a lot of people are getting mad about this. If the competitors say ask, the ref has to ask. But the fact that he kept repeating it was kind of annoying. In the end, though, I'm not even going to really talk about it. Swagger
was very in control of this match. And then the ending was Ricardo always holds the bucket and the towel. And Coulter came over, and I think he did something to...
Jack Swagger had him in the ankle lock, the Patriot lock.
And then Coulter comes over and grabs Del Rio's towel, throws it in the ring, signaling throwing in the towel. You know, I'm giving up as a manager for my competitor.
And Chioda,
and the match was called off.
And a Chioda, who is a senior official, saw the towel, rang the bell. Ricardo had a fit. And then Rod Zapata, this motherfucker, this BAMF, comes out. And this is he's a rookie official, comes out and starts arguing with Mike Chioda. They go to an instant replay for the first time in WWE history. They had
a 26-inch TV on the announce table.
Oh, my God. Absolutely perfect. And is this going to open up instant replay to WWE? Let me know in the comment section below, guys, because this could alter everything. I mean, I think Art O'Cal said it best.
We've seen BS finishes in the past, and this makes no sense.
If they have an instant replay finish.
It makes sense because it's a way to have...
Both of them had a victory. So this is kind of a way,
But where does Swagger go from here? That's interesting.
I think these two are going to keep competing, honestly. Del Rio won in the end with a cross arm bar after the match was restarted. Just super weird. And either way, they're going to lose to Dolph Ziggler because they would have just stripped Dolph if they didn't want him to have the title. Next up was The Shield taking on Team Hell No. Very good tornado tag match. Very interesting.
Every tag match should be a tornado tag after watching this one.
The team moves, Daniel Bryan and Kane had some good tag team moves. The Shield had good tag team moves. You guys really kind of have to watch it for yourself, but the end saw a good tag team maneuver. Roman Reigns had Daniel Bryan up on top of his shoulders in kind of like a torture rack. Seth Rollins jumped up, slammed him. And that was the 1-2-3 pin. And the Shield now holds the tag titles and the United States titles. So look for the Shield to dominate on TV. And then Randy Orton took on the Big Show. Thoughts on that one?
I wasn't really into this match. Big Show really didn't get... He got his offense early,
hashtag
but he wasn't getting his signature moves as much as Orton was. So it was really a match for Orton to have most of the control towards the end and win in his hometown. And he got some great pops.
Hashtag broken candlesticks. Big Show kept breaking the candlesticks. There was a couple good spots. Big Show did a super kick to Orton, who was taking a ladder out onto the ring. The finish, though, Randy hit an RKO, and then he hit an RKO on a chair. And then finally, the band move, It Is Extreme, hit a punt kick on Big Show. A lot of fans were super happy about that. Not really much to talk about, like Hurricane said. It was, just set up Orton to win in his hometown. Then comes time for what people thought was going to be the main event, but it wasn't. And wow.
John Cena match of the and night. Ryback.
Match of the night. In my opinion, it was 100% match of the night. People are going to bitch about John Cena saying he can't have a good match. If you think that, I can't stand people like that. Just unsub from me.
If you choose if you decide that the match is bad before it starts, or that if Cena loses or wins that it's bad, then no.
Yeah, exactly. This match had everything. They had great spots. It wasn't just a finisher party like John Cena versus Rocket Mania.
I think Ryback looks stronger now.
He does. It absolutely fantastic match. Shell shocks, attitude adjustments. Multiple weapons.
Did you think it was over when Cena jumped from the first row onto Ryback on the table?
No, that was a Kofi Kingston Madison Square Garden spot. I didn't think it was going to be over from there. But in the end, though, we're going to keep this one short and simple. John Cena was going for an attitude adjustment on top of the stage after he hit Ryback with two fire extinguisher hits. But Ryback reversed it, picks him up kind of like a spine buster and runs him into the stage. And they go through the lights. The lights kind of blew. The camera stalled for about a minute and a half, I'm guessing, so they could place him just right. And in the end, John Cena was put on a stretcher. Ryback was carried out. It was a no-contest finish. A lot of people are going to say the match sucked just because of the finish. But the match, a finish has made both guys look good. And they basically set up another match between them. There wasn't an interference from Paul Heyman or The Shield like people had speculated. I enjoyed it. My match of the night. You guys can watch it, Hurricane, if you want to jump in really quick. But the main event, Brock Lesnar versus Triple H. Now, I want to ask your opinion on this, Hurricane, because we talked about this in Mania.
Yeah.
Is Triple H's pyro budget for the year gone?
It could be. He spent all that money early, and so they just scrapped the entrance tonight and said, go attack Brock on the ramp.
Absolutely. The match, very back and forth. The new steel cage, a lot of people are going to say, it's not a new... What were people expecting? I liked it. It was a foot taller.
Punjabi prison.
It was a foot taller. The top was super clean. I liked the shininess of it. There's three panels. People thought they were going to break through it. They didn't in the end. I really love the new cage. I think it looks simpler. it must be easier to work with. In my opinion, you guys, you got to watch this match if you want to see it. In the end, Brock Lesnar was about to get destroyed by Triple H, who had a sledgehammer spray-painted silver to match in with a cage. But Paul Heyman, who had came in previously and got pedigreed, hit a low blow on Triple H, allowed Brock Lesnar to get the offense, hit him in the jaw with a sledgehammer, then hit an F5, and Brock this whole match was selling a knee injury. I honestly think he's going to get his own WWE movie after the way he sold that.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
And in the end, Brock Lesnar is victorious. Triple H went out for the last 5 minutes getting carried out and then eventually
walked
out.
The end was kind of weird because there really wasn't a match on this card that should have ended the show. Because if you're putting together this card, you obviously already know Cena and Ryback's going to be a no contest finish.
You don't
and that's kind of a crappy way to end the show that way.
Yep.
And Brock and Lesnar, Lesnar and Triple H, it's not major enough because these guys are minor characters that appear 5 times a year at most.
I think Art O'Kell said it was the first time that a main event's been headlined by a part-timer. So that's pretty much it. If you guys
only Undertaker can do that.
What is your final rating for the show? Out of 10?
I give it an 8.
8 out of 10? I give it an 8.5 out of 10, guys. If you want to get the full results, come over to the stream right now. And until next time, we will see you all later.